Very warm welcome in the class of numerical methods. We are in the module of finding out the roots of the algebraic and transcendental equations using numerical techniques. In this particular module, we have already gone through two methods. The first one is bisection method and the next one is regular falsi method. Today in this particular lecture, we are going to describe the third one, that is Newton-Raphson method. In this particular method, what are the benefits one person can get will also be discussed. Along with that, the working rule, the limitations and a little bit geometry behind this particular concept will be explained. So let us proceed for the main topic. Suppose we have a function given as fx and our target is to find out the root of this. So, as it is classically not possible for us to find it out, suppose we are assuming that x0 be an approximate root of the given function fx equal to 0. So, x0 is one of our approximate root, and we are also assuming that x1 is an exact root of this given equation fx. So if we want to find out the relationship between x1 and x0, we will get x1 is equal to x0 plus h, where h is the deviation of the approximate root from the exact root. So now think about it. If we can find out h and if we can make h minimized, then obviously we will reach to x1 from x0, which is actually our target. We may not reach to the exact root, but we can reach to the root with a very little error. So, as x1 is the correct root or exact root, we can write that f of x1 is equal to 0. Now, next line we can write in place of x1, x0 plus h, and it is equal to also 0. Now if we go back to our previous studies where we have learned the Taylor series, using that Taylor series, if I write it as f of x0 plus h as f of x0 plus h f dash x0 plus h square by factorial 2 f double dash x0 and so on, this is coming from our known Taylor series expansion of a given function, obviously satisfying all the required conditions. So using this, I can write fx0 plus h is equal to 0, and f of x0 plus h is this. We can write it as f of x0 plus h f dash x0 plus h square by factorial 2 f double dash x0 plus dot 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 is equal to 0. Now we are going to use one common sense over here, and we can say that as the true root is x1 and h is equal to x1 minus x0, the number h actually measures the distance or the error. Now, as our h will be small, h square, h cube will be smaller. So, we can use the linear approximation. Here, this linear approximation means actually the tangent line consideration. Linear approximation means actually we are considering the tangent. we will make it more clear while when we are going to discuss the geometry behind this. So using this logic, we are neglecting the second and higher order derivatives, and we are now writing by neglecting that f of x1 is equal to f of x0 plus h. We can't write it equal now because we are discarding some terms, so it will be f of x0 plus h f dash x0, because we are neglecting the higher order terms starting from second order, because we are approximating linearly, and therefore we can write the expression of h here as f of x0 by f dash x0 as f of x1 is equal to 0. Now please concentrate on this part, because this is very important. We got x1 is equal to x0 plus h. Now we can write it as it is x0 minus f of x0 by f dash x0. Look at this. If I find it out, there will be a minus sign in the context of h. Okay. So we get our calculation as x1 is equal to x0 minus fx0 by f dash x0. Before going into the further steps, I just want to know from you that when we can successfully write this expression and when we can proceed, what is the restriction over here so that we can apply this process? I know that you are now able to identify this particular condition, that is, here f dash x0 has to be not equal to 0. If f dash x0 is equal to 0, then fx0 by f dash x0 is non-existing, and if it is non-existing, then it is not possible for us to find out the value of h. So obviously we will not be able to find out x1. So once it is clear, we can go for x2, x3, up to that particular steps or iteration, until and unless we are reaching to our desired accuracy. So in general, the formula can be written as working formula: xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn by f dash xn. So in a nutshell, we are able to write the step 1 as, for the purpose of Newton-Raphson method for finding out the root of fx equal to 0, we have to choose one x0 as an initial approximation and we have to find f of x0 and f dash x0, because fx is given to us, so we can find it out easily. After that, in step 2, we have to compute the next approximation for x1 of the required root using the following formula. The formula is x1 is equal to x0 minus f of x0 by f dash x0, keeping that information in our mind that f dash x0 is not equal to 0. That is why we have calculated this part in the step 1. And in the step 3, we will compute the successive approximations for the required root using the same formula. In general, we can write it as x of n plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn by f dash x n. And in the final step, that is our step 4, we will continue this step 3 up to the prescribed or desired accuracy. Okay, now we will solve one problem for getting the thing more clear, but before that I just want to mention one or two things to you. The first one is that in case of bisection method, we need two initial values of A and B such that FA into FB will be less than 0. In case of regular falsi method, here also we need A and B such that FA into FB is less than 0. But in case of Newton-Raphson method, we need initial approximation only one as x0, but here we are having one condition that f dash x0 has not to be equal to 0 for applying this condition or this particular method. And there are also one job I am leaving to you for your inquisitiveness, that is, you please check the rate of convergence of all these methods. And why the rate of convergence is something like that, please try to identify. And depending on this rate of convergence, please make the order of bisection method, regular falsi method, and Newton-Raphson method. So next, we will proceed further for a particular problem. So our problem is to find out the root of x cube minus x minus 4 is equal to 0 using Newton-Raphson method, correct up to 5 decimal places. So here our fx is x cube minus x minus 4, f0 is minus 4, f1 is minus 4, f2 is 2. Now, we can get any of these initial approximations. Not only that, we can take any other number, but rationally, if we think that in this particular closed interval, the root is guaranteed, so we can take, I am saying, repeating it again, it is not at all mandatory, it is just for the calculational point of view. Just one benefit some students can get, that if I take the middle point of these two, that is 1.5, as my initial approximation, we may reach to our desired accuracy in less number of steps. But again, I am saying it is not at all mandatory. Now, f dash x is required for finding out f dash 0 or f dash f dash x0, f dash x1 and so on. So f dash x for this particular problem is 3x square minus 1. Now if I put 1.5 over here, I can see that it is not equal to 0. So the process is now convergent if I start it from taking x0 is equal to 1.5. So x1 is x0 minus f of x0 by f dash x0, what I can write as 1.5 minus, after doing this calculation, 1.5 whole cube minus 1.5 minus 4 by 3 into 1.5 whole square minus 1. Ultimately, we are going to get 1.8695652. But if I write like this, it will not be so much cleanliness we are exhibiting. For that purpose, again, we are depending on the tabular form. So what table we are going to find it right now? N. Then we are writing as xn. Then we are calculating fxn, the things what sequentially are required for each and every steps. We are writing it in column wise, f dash xn, and finally our xn plus 1, that means the formula or the working rule. You know the working rule, xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus fxn by f dash xn. So when n is equal to 0, it is my 1.5. If I calculate, already if I have calculated the thing, we will get by putting this as minus 2.125, and f dash xn we are getting as 5.75, and here we are getting as 1.8695652. In the next step, when n is equal to 1, then this value will be coming as xn, because we are now going to find out x2, it is my x1. So 1.8695652, and we are getting it here 0.660776, and here we are getting 9.4858223, and here we are getting 1.7994524. So I just want to request you to recall the number of steps what you have implemented in bisection method and regular falsi method. It was near about 6 or 7 steps you have generated there. But here look at this, after third step, that is at fourth step, we are getting as 1.796328, and here the functional value is 0.000052. I am not going further now. I just want to request you, if you see at a particular point the functional value is 0.000052, it indicates automatically that the functional value is very, very close to 0. And if the functional value is very, very close to 0 at a particular point, that means that point is going to be a root of that particular given function. Though we will compute the next steps, because we are using not that sense, we are using the sense that consecutive difference of xn plus 1 has to be 0 up to 5 decimal places, then we are actually able to claim that it is correct up to 5 decimal places. So what we are getting here as 8.6803825, and in this position it is 1.796328. Can you identify that what you got here, it must come from here? So here it is also 1.796328, and again after putting this value, and taking this ratio, you are getting again 1.796328. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need 5 decimal places, but up to 6 decimal places, they are exactly same. That means we don't need to proceed further. This is going to be my desired root. Just for a caution, the value of the root is what I will write. Will I write 1.796328 or will I write only 1.7963 or will I write 1.79632? I am writing it because I have to go for the 5 decimal places, and this is 5 decimal places. Now one question can be coming in our mind, that if I want to write it 5 decimal places, I must think about the rounding off. So for this 8, it has to be 3. But for your information, this is written after rounding it off, because look at this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is written up to 6th places. That means we are calculating it up to 7th places. We have written it up to 6th places after rounding it off. And from that, we are taking the value, the desired root, as up to correct up to 5 decimal places. So this is the whole thing related to Newton-Raphson method. Now, just we are going to conclude this particular lecture. But before that, I want to request you to follow these references for your further study. And also, solve these problems along with other problems. These are just a sample problems given to you as an assignment. So, thank you all. Happy listening, happy learning.